Hi, this is Ale with Bridging Apps. Today we will be talking about iCloud. iCloud is a built-in service that comes on all Apple devices that stores and keeps data safe in the cloud and automatically updates across all devices. This includes photos, files, notes, passwords, and more. You can choose what you want backed up and what you don't. This is a great feature for users who switch phones often as they can get all of their data on their new device, or for users who take lots of pictures and videos and don't have enough device storage left. Users can access iCloud from any web browser at iCloud.com or set it up on their devices. Every Apple device includes 5 GB of free iCloud storage and the option to set up a free email account with the iCloud domain. So instead of at gmail.com or at yahoo.com, your email would be at iCloud.com. This is completely optional and not required to use iCloud services. To view your iCloud storage and customize the feature you'd like to use, first locate and open the Settings app. You must be signed in with your Apple ID to set up your iCloud. You will know you are signed in if you see your name in the top row. Tap on your name, then tap on iCloud. You will now see this colorful bar in the top section of your screen. This is your iCloud storage. It will tell you how much storage you have used and then break it down in different colored sections so you can see what is taking up your storage. For example, most of my storage is being taken up by that yellow area, which is photos. As mentioned previously, iCloud provides 5 GB of free storage to back up all your data on your device, but you can purchase more. Tap on Manage Account Storage, then Change Storage Plan to view your options. The plan that has a blue check mark on it is what you are currently on. I am currently on the 50 GB plan, which costs 99 cents per month. If you need to downgrade, you can do so by tapping on Downgrade Options. Tap on Back until you return to the main iCloud screen. You can view which apps are using iCloud in the middle section of the screen. Tap Show All to view them all. You can now choose which apps you'd like to be backed up to iCloud and synced to other devices using the same Apple ID. Being synced means whatever you add on one device will be available on all other devices logged into your iCloud account if that app is backed up. This includes notes, calendar events, contacts, and even reminders. Let's walk through what turning iCloud for some of these apps means. Having photos turned on stores all your photos and videos in iCloud and allows you to view and share them on all your devices and on iCloud.com. Tapping on it will show you how many photos and/or videos are currently in iCloud and allows you to optimize iPhone storage by automatically replacing photos and videos on your device with smaller versions when you are low on storage. Full resolution versions are available in iCloud and can be downloaded at any time. Turning on Safari saves bookmarks across other devices, and turning on passwords and keychain securely stores passwords, credit cards, and more in iCloud. It allows you to share passwords with people you trust and autofills your information in Safari and other web browsers. Turning on Messages securely stores messages in iCloud in case you need to restore your device or set up a new one, and most importantly, turning on Find My allows you to sign into iCloud.com and see your device's location if it is lost. Lastly, turning on iCloud Drive saves documents to iCloud and allows you to access them on other mobile devices signed into iCloud. This means that a document that you worked on your laptop can be accessed on your iPhone through iCloud.
For individuals who want to back up their device to iCloud, they can turn on iCloud Backup to back up their iPhone so they can restore their data in case they lose their device or get a new one. Tapping on it will show you the last time your device was successfully backed up and the backup size.
We hope you have enjoyed this video. For more tips like this, visit www.bridgingapps.org.